talking about the elections. 16th of February will be the general elections on the federal level. And we're going to be switching our conversation now, talking about underage voting. And I have here with me Adetayo Adesola. Thanks for being here today.
Thank you, Ruka.
Yes, it's one of those things that's continued to be a bane of our electoral process. With every election cycle, we see pictures of obviously underage voters in line, fairly in some particular regions of the country, you know, queuing to vote. And there's already whispers about that happening again, especially, like we've said earlier in our earlier conversations, with the appearance of governors from a neighboring country coming to campaign for the ruling party. And people are saying, oh, that's sort of a prelude to what might be happening in the coming days. With the election, with what INEC has done so far, trying to be very thorough with the PVCs and registration, do you think that should be still be a worry?
It's still a worry because I feel like INEC has not done enough in terms of advocacy, in terms of trying to sensitize the public about why underage voting is wrong, because the Constitution says that you have to be 18 before you can vote. And it's a problem for Nigerians because it's almost unlawful. And when you have, because most of those, the regions where these underage voters are, where we have underage voters is because they are not that literate, and so education is a problem. And it could also be solved if we had a better database in Nigeria, where we can actually get the right figures of people that are eligible to vote. But now, as we have 84 million people voting, we don't know how many people are.
You think that makes it harder to spot, right? Like, with 84 million people registered to vote, let's say give or take 40 million show up to vote on election day. It makes it harder to track.
Election malpractice is always easier when the people that are supposed to vote don't turn out. And so that's when they can always pad the stats, basically.
Yeah. What sort of things should we be looking at on the election day now? I mean, I know in the past, like I said, we've seen pictures on Twitter, on Facebook, you know. Are those enough? What should citizens be looking out for, trying to do when they notice things like this?
They should basically speak out, and they should even take it beyond Twitter, because we have enough of Twitter advocates already. We need to come to the streets and, you know, make our presence felt. And with that way, when they see that the citizens, the young Nigerians, are rallied towards, you know, participating, expressing their suffrage, then, you know, it's just a bit harder for the people that want to do bad to do bad.
Let's talk about you. You're a first-time voter now,
yes,
right? Why did it take you so long to start voting in Nigeria?
It took me time to actually realize how important it was for as a Nigerian to express my my suffrage, basically. And then, you know, because in Nigeria, the process is a bit difficult, so you don't want to really stretch yourself to go vote. But this year's election, last year I registered for my TVC. It took me like 3 days to actually get it done, but I said I was going to get it done. I've not collected my PVC yet, but I'm going to collect it this week. I just realized that. It was because like 2 weeks ago, when I searched for it, the data, you know, there's a website you go to. He told me it wasn't available, so I was even wondering already. I was almost giving up, but I decided to check again, and I'm going to get my PVC.
Okay. Do you have a lot of people like you who were probably eligible the last time who have decided to come out this time to register? Why they decided that this is the time to?
I think actually that Nigerians are getting, you know, they're getting more inclined towards politics and understanding. I think the advocacy, even though we complain about Twitter advocacy going to the streets, but I think it's a process. Even based on even the amount of registered voters we have compared to the last election. And so it's a process that, you know, that will take some time, because the election malpractice has been since like independence, and based on the fact that we're still growing as a nation, and just based on the growth that we're having, although the growth is slow, but I think we can still look at the fact that we have gotten some considerable mileage in terms of electoral participation in Nigeria.
Let's talk back now about the underage voting now, because it's something that's a big worry for a lot of people. First of all, how do they even get to register in the first place, you know? And then it throws up questions of, if they're not registered, how are they now on the queue? And how do you even identify who's underage? Is it enough to see someone who looks young and assume they're young? I mean, if you shaved off your beard now, you could, I know I'm giving you a compliment. How do we know these things for sure? You know, is there sort of a way of knowing? And are party agents supposed to be enough of a police sort of system. Because I mean, if the APC and the PDP, for example, are vying for an election and one is accused of underage voting, is that enough of a, is the other party's agent enough of a police for the situation?
Well, the thing is, I feel the, as I, let me go back to the point of advocacy.
Yeah.
That's the first point. And because Nigeria, facts are hard to come by because, you know, basically how we get information in this country is based on one party accusing the other party. But what needs to be done is security needs to be tightened, basically, in terms of before they register, when they register, and even when they are going to vote. Cast their votes.
Yeah.
And another thing that needs to be considered is the fact that we need to improve our database, basically.
Yeah.
Then the education has to be there also,
yeah.
Basically.
Do you think we're overblowing the situation? I mean, because some people argue, okay, let's assume they're really underage voters, because all these are still allegations, but let's assume they're really underage voters. I think that many to swing an entire election, is this something that should really worry us? I mean, are we going to have 5 million underage voters? You know what I'm saying? I mean, the last election was won and lost with 2 million votes.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not saying we should condone it, but is it enough to worry a candidate?
I think it should. Because, you know, these numbers actually do count. And one thing I should also say is that in terms of this underage voting, when there are allegations of these LGAs that are registering underage voters, or they are people, underage voters are casting their votes, the government needs to take it quite seriously and even probably suspend, that's what I would recommend, suspend that polling unit, basically, from what's it called? From the election process. Basically. Then,
but who's guilty here? Because, I mean, I don't want to make it a partisan issue, but, I mean, who are we accusing here now? Because if this has happened in the last elections, we're expecting this to happen again. Is there a particular party that's guilty, or is it across board? And why is the other party letting it happen, if at all?
I think it's across board, and it's because there's no firmness from the government or from the law enforcement agencies to stop these kind of things. And I think it also goes back to the database, because sometimes some of these people are not even on the record, basically. Nigeria doesn't have a comprehensive database, so you can't even know who Adetayo Adeshola is from Oyo State, you know. So that's the problem, and that's the problem. And it also goes even with the population, the census that we do. So if we have a more comprehensive and robust database, you know, I feel like it will curb this to a certain degree.
Yeah. So just on a final note, before we leave now, I'm talking about first-time voters like you, or young people like you who are hoping to participate in these elections. What's your word for them? What are your expectations on the 16th of February?
For first-time voters? Okay, well, I feel like it's going to be tough. It's not going to be a very easy process, but you know, you have to, if you believe in your country, you have to, you know, suffer a bit, basically. You have to come out of your comfort zone to show that you care about Nigeria, because it's easy to talk about it. In fact, I'm tired of talking about it. I just want to act. I feel like we have so many smart people. We have people that can really, you know, make right decisions, basically. And so they have to come out and, you know, put their action and put their foot on the ground, because so many times we have cases of people not turning out for elections, or people not, they don't even give a damn about the country.
Yeah.
So that's what.
Well, thank you very much. Yeah. Like you say, please go out and pick up your PVCs. I think the 8th of February, I believe, or the 9th, I'm not sure now, but this week. Make sure you pick up a PVC before the end of this week, because by the end of this week, you will not be able to get your PVCs anymore. And elections are the 16th of February, and you will be able to vote. And I'm sure we all want to be part of that process to elect our leaders across board. We're not just talking about the president now, the House of Representatives, state governors, and local representatives. Please go out and get your PVCs so that on these election days, you do have your say. One vote is a lot. Do not be one of those people who think your vote does not count. Like we've said earlier on the show, the 2015 elections showed us that our votes count. And if you don't have any other reason to vote, look back at that time and see what a difference it made. Thanks for being here today. Thanks for joining us. And I'll see you next time.